Hello friends, welcome to my channel World of Science with me Asim Saba. So this video is a continuation of my previous video. In this video, I am going to talk about the preservation by pasteurization. If you have missed my previous video, I have linked in the description, you can have a look. Content of this video. What is pasteurization? What is the purpose of pasteurization? What are the methods of pasteurization? And what are the effects of pasteurization? If you are new to my channel, please do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you never miss my video. So, what is pasteurization? The process of pasteurization was named after Louis Pasteur, who discovered spoilage organism could be inactivated in wine by applying heat at temperature below its boiling point. It was later applied to the milk and remains the most important operation in the process of milk. So, coming to the definition of the pasteurization, it is defined as the heating of every particle of milk or milk product to specific temperature for a specified period of time without allowing recontamination of milk or milk product during the heat treatment process. What may be the purpose of pasteurization? The first purpose is very important, that is public health aspect, to keep milk and milk products safe for human consumption by destroying all bacteria that may be harmful to health. Public health, that may be the purpose for pasteurization. The second comes is the keeping quality aspect. To improve the keeping quality of milk and milk product, pasteurization can destroy some undesirable enzymes and many spoilage bacteria. The shelf life can be 7, 10, 14 or up to 16 days. There is one most heat resistant pathogen which is found in milk is Coxsalidae vernetii. What are the methods of pasteurization? Well, there are two basic methods. The first comes the batch method. This method uses a vat pasteurizer which consists of a jacket. You can see in the diagram, the vat surrounded by either circulating water, steam or heating coils of water or steam. Number two is a continuation method. This method has several advantages over the vat method, that is nothing but the batch method, the most important being time and energy saving. For most continuous processing, a high temperature short time pasteurization is used. The milk is heated to a temperature of 72 degrees Celsius and held for 15 seconds and then cooled rapidly. In this method, the heat treatment is accomplished using a plate heat exchanger, as you can see in the diagram. What is low temperature high time? The milk is applied to 63 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes before cooled to 7 degrees Celsius. High temperature short time 71.5 degrees Celsius at least 15 seconds before cooled to 10 degrees Celsius. This method is more helpful in retention of nutritional and sensory quality. It is famously called as flash pasteurization. It is the most common method which is applied to milk which has been marketed in. The next one is the ultra temperature. The milk is applied to 138 degrees Celsius for at least 2 seconds. Extreme pasteurization kills all microorganisms, keeping milk in a closed sterile container at room temperature. So what are the effects of pasteurization? Is there any effect of doing pasteurization on the milk and the milk product? Let's see. On food, there will be a minor changes in nutritional and sensorial characteristics. The shelf life will be the few days or weeks. On color, flavor and aroma, the color deterioration by enzymatic browning takes place because of the presence of the enzyme called as polyphenolase oxidase. This can be promoted by the presence of oxygen. The whiteness of raw milk and pasteurized milk differs. This is due to homogenization. There will be a small loss of volatile aroma compounds during pasteurization of milk. Thank you viewers for watching my video. Do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon. Keep supporting and keep watching.